I think it's time for me to offer my own RBE challenge. The challenge that I'm offering is somewhat similar to the one that's being offered by Matt Berkowitz of the Zeitgeist Movement. The offer he's making, or the challenge he's making, is something for skeptics of the RBE concept to write an essay, a 1,000-word essay, providing evidence disproving the concept, or at least part of the concept. I'm hoping that Stefan Molyneux takes part in this essay, since he's such a huge opponent of the resource-based economic model. And when you look at the debates he's done with Peter Joseph, you'll see what I mean. But back to my particular challenge. And the thing about my challenge is that it's somewhat less complicated than what Matt Berkowitz is talking about, because it goes like this. If you want to convince me that the resource-based economic model won't work, you are going to have to prove to me that the human race is exempt from the laws of physics. Again, I say, if you can prove to me that the human race is exempt from the laws of physics, I will reject the resource-based economic model. I might even go anarcho-capitalist or something to that effect. And the reason why, or one of the reasons why, or the main reason why I'm such an RBE advocate is because I'm under the impression that it's the best chance we have, of achieving human survival. The way things are now, it looks like the human race is on a rapid road to self-inflicted extinction. And I don't want that to happen, because I have the misfortune of being a member of the human race, which I used to often refer to as being the ultimate manifestation of evolution gone mad. But the point is that if the human race becomes extinct, I'm not going to have any audience members for my web comics, and that's not going to work for me. But, as I said before, human survival is the issue. Even though in the grand scheme of things, the survival of the human race is not important, it's not necessary, it's not unnecessary either. But the point is that since I have a bias toward human survival, I'm going to do what I can to make sure that it is achieved. Let's see, the other thing I wanted to bring up in relation to this is that there are basically two ways, at least there are two ways that I know of, two basic ways that I know of, that the human race can attain survival. One way is to adapt to living in a technological world. The other way is to regress technologically. This sort of thing is because the way the human mind currently works is incompatible with the technological world, because if we were compatible, we wouldn't be on the verge of extinction. If we regress technologically, our chances of survival might increase, because we won't have the technology that would end up destroying our species and most of life on Earth. But I'm of the mind that we gotta adapt to technology, since it's already here, and I prefer technology anyway. Or I prefer the advanced technology that we have anyway, as opposed to the less advanced technology of a pre-industrial era. Adapting to the technological era that we live in, I think it best be achieved with an RBE, because an RBE is based on the scientific method, after all. And the past four centuries or so, the scientific method as we know it has had a very high level of success regarding advances in technology. I mean, without the scientific method, we wouldn't have this internet we're using, we wouldn't have cars, we wouldn't have airplanes, we wouldn't have international space stations. and have iPods and iPhones and all these other goodies that a lot of us love so much. So, from what I can see, if the scientific method can be used to achieve all these other goodies, then it should be possible to use the scientific method to improve human society. Of course, the skeptics have their explanation for why it won't work, but I'm going to reject those explanations unless they can use scientific methods to prove that the human race is exempt from the laws of physics, and thus the scientific method it can't be used to improve human society. I think I might want to stop the video here. According to my notes, I don't have much else to say unless I want to buy my new webcam. I might as well do that. Yeah, a new webcam. I gotta bring this up quick because it's not really relevant to the main thing of this video. But anyway, the webcam that comes from my laptop has is way better than any other webcam I've used, so it's kind of inspired me to do more videos, and that's one reason why I'm doing this video. In the case of this video, my main concern is to tell the opponents of the resource-based economy that if they want me to reject the resource-based economic model, you have to scientifically prove that the human race is exempt from the laws of physics. That's it. See you later, Ralph Nader.